earrings.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is my distinct honor to welcome you here today to rejoice with Aaron and Julie on this, their wedding day. We are gathered here to bear witness to their shared desire to henceforth walk the road of life together. Do you give this woman to be wed to this man?
My mother and I do.
Thank you very much, sir. Please be seated. Right now, we will take a moment to recognize Aaron's and Julie's family members and to thank them for their love, support, and devotion as they grew from childhood into the two beautiful individuals who stand before us today. We thank you for teaching them values and for showing them the beauty and joy of loving another. This is also a time to celebrate all of those who have touched their lives and who are not able to be with us in person today, but who are here in spirit. Let us please remember them with a moment of silence. Two lives shared with love can hold more fulfillment and happiness than either life alone. Aaron, are you ready to enter into this marriage with Julie, believing that the love you share and your faith in each other will endure all things?
I am.
Julie, are you ready to enter into this marriage with Aaron, believing that the love you share and your faith in each other will endure all things?
Yes.
Marriage is a coming together of two lives and a celebration of the love of two people. It's more than that, too. The love that Aaron and Julie feel for one another is the flowering of a seed that their parents planted in their hearts years ago. As they embrace one another in their love, so do they embrace the families which have been brought together on this happy occasion. As a sign of their love for their family, Aaron and Julie would like to offer two symbols of eternal love, roses, to their mothers, Pam Hanlon and Suzanne Savini. Aaron and Julie want you to know that your efforts were not in vain and that your love is very much appreciated. They thank you for everything instilled in them. These roses are a promise that no matter how far apart you are, that you are not forgotten, and as a reminder that you are always in their hearts and prayers. To love is to enter a whole new world, a world of togetherness, a world of sharing all that is deepest and dearest within your hearts. To love is to remember and to keep alive forever all of those unique qualities that drew you to one another in the beginning. Those first halting phrases, that wonderful feeling of oneness when your eyes first met. To love is to constantly search for new ways to bring each other happiness, to make the most of every moment that you share together, and to marvel at how your feelings for one another keep rising to new dimensions. To love is to greet each day with anticipation, always eager for another opportunity to share new adventures and to gather up new memories together. To love is to follow the rainbow through the rain, to be able to laugh at yourselves, and be willing to say, I was wrong, I'm sorry. Because to love is to forgive, and more importantly, to forget, and to always believe and trust in one another. To love is to be happy to be together. To love is coming together from the pathways of your past, and then moving forward, hand in hand, along the uncharted roads of your future, ready to risk, to dream, and to dare, believing that all things are possible with faith and love. I'd like to ask Joanne King if she would please come forward at this time.
We are anything but wonderful. Love is looking out in the same direction. It is linking our strength to put a common load. It is pushing together towards the fall horizons hand in hand. Love is knowing that when our strengths falter, we can borrow the strength of someone who cares. Love is a strange awareness that our sorrows would be shared and be made lighter by sharing, that joys will be enriched and multiplied by the joys of another. Love is knowing someone else cares and that we are not alone in life. Congratulations and love.
There lies a promise. Perfectly born, divinely created, and intimately shared, it is a place where the hope and majesty of beginnings reside, where all things are made possible by the astounding love shared by two spirits. As you hold each other's hands in this promise and eagerly look into the future in each other's eyes, may your unconditional love and devotion take you to places where you've both only dreamed, where you will for a lifetime of happiness, sheltered in the warmth of each other's arms. Marriage is love, walking hand in hand together. Marriage is laughing with each other about silly little things, and learning to discuss big things with both care and tenderness. In marriage, love is trusting each other when you're apart. It's getting over disappointments and hurts, knowing these are personal relationships. It's the realization that there is no one else in this world with whom you would rather be than the one to whom you're married. It's thinking of new things to do together. It's growing old together. Marriage is being in love for the rest of your life. Aaron, do you take Julie to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in holy matrimony? Do you promise to love her, to honor and cherish her, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, and to be to her in all things a good and faithful husband, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Julie, do you take Aaron to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in holy matrimony? Do you promise to love him, to honor and cherish him, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, and to be to him in all things a good and faithful wife, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Bless their marriage, O God, as they begin their journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead before the road turns and bends. Help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing and no one is perfect, and to look for the good in all things and all people, including themselves. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams and fears, even though they may not always understand them. Help them to learn from each other and to help each other to grow, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Amen. Do you have the rings? The ring is a symbol of unbroken unity. It portrays completeness and eternity. May the imperishable substance of these rings reflect a love shining increasing radiance throughout your years together. May God bless these rings which you give to the other as a sign of your love, trust, and devotion. Aaron, please place the ring on Julie's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring. I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol
of my love.
Of my love.
My faith and our strength.
My faith
and our strength together.
Together.
And my covenant.
And my covenant.
To learn and grow.
To learn and grow.
With you.
With you.
Julie, please place the ring on Aaron's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
My faith.
My faith.
And our strength together.
And our strength together.
And my covenant.
And my covenant.
To learn and grow with you.
To learn and grow with you.
Aaron and Julie, as the two of you enter into this marriage, uniting you as husband and wife, and as you this day affirm your faith and love for one another, I ask that you always remember to cherish each other as special and unique individuals. Respect the thoughts, ideas, and suggestions of one another. Be able to forgive. Do not hold grudges. And live each day that you may share it together, as from this day forward, you shall be each other's home, comfort, and refuge. Your love strengthened by your respect and kindness for each other. We shall now perform the wine ceremony. This ceremony represents that just as two wines were combined into a single wine, today these two individual lives are now combined into one single life. Drinking the combined wine signifies the commitment that you now make to live your lives as one family, as one team. May you remember this day of commitment you've sealed with the drinking of new wine, joining your lives as one. Would Sherry Workman please come forward?
Happiness in marriage is not something that just happened. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other. Not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, and understanding. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each of you can grow. It is common search for the good and for the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It's not only marrying the right partner, but it's being the right person.
We ask that the Holy Spirit of love may deepen the lives of Aaron and Julie, May the relationship which today has been expressed continue to grow in the years to come. And whatever changes time may bring, let this wedding ceremony remain as a treasured memory and a guide to life. May you have many joys and be the light of each other's days. May all that you are always be in love, and may all that is love always be in you. May you always see and encourage the best in each other. May the challenges that life brings your way make your marriage grow stronger. May you always be each other's best friend and greatest love. By the power vested in me by the state of Pennsylvania, I now declare that you be husband and wife. Aaron, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is absolutely my honor and my privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Hanlon.
That was All right, ladies, come on over. That way a little bit. Am I there? Let's go with you. Back on the ball. All right, guys, right here at me. Let your flowers fall.
Nice pose, babe.
Hold on. Can you come out of there? Sir, where's he at? There. Oh, there you are. Come on up, bud. Right in there with the ladies. Yeah, now I want your back against the wall. I'm about your jacket. Let me have your jacket.
How
you
doing?
Hi. You know
my text I sent you last night?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, come on. It's only been 10 minutes. Started cheating. Yeah, so your question was back as long as possible. Ladies. This is break time.
Do you think it's cancel charge?
I mean, I know you want a break, but go around behind the guy.
Jesus. I don't know where you want me to go.
How about you stand on the end? We'll just stand on the end. Now we're in the same height. All right, stand behind the gentleman or gentlemen you walked out with. Got two? One, two. So you're here, you're just on the end on your own.
I'm just hanging out.
Ladies, kind of leaning, wrap your arms around, put the flowers on their chest, lean over. There you go, just like that. Other hand on that side, outside hand.
It's okay.
But to me, it's a little sweaty. All right, troops. Right here at me. You have sunglasses on, you take them off. Just put them in your hand, that's fine. There we go. We have to take a sunglass off, he's glaring at me now. Give me a smile, brother, come on. There we go. One more time. One more. Beautiful. Come on over. Huh? Other side.
Right here?
Come on, guys, move on. You might as well just move on down. You'll be over here. Take your sunglasses back off.
Girl, guy. Another girl, another guy.
And then just guys. We have our metrosexual couple. All right, guys, tighten it up. Slide together. Turn towards your wife, my good man. There you go. All right. Looks uncovered by the guys. I'm sorry, dude.
You're good, you're good.
All right, guys, right here at us. A little smile. You guys stand right where you are. Okay, don't close up. Just stay where you are. Keep coming, guys. Bob, we're back.
No?
Go ahead, give it a shot.
Woo-hoo!
Good. Each other. Give her a kiss. That guy's right here, me. Nice and close. Go closer. Flower down just a tick. Good. Come on, Aaron. Come on, man. Good, he's good. Can't hurt him. Perfect. This is the one you're talking about for the pneumatic, correct? By the door? Does that make sense to him?
Photographer, nice shot.
Guys, right here, me. And you really tight here. Beautiful. Nice smile, Aaron. Welcome to you, man. There you go.
And now, the parents of the groom, Jim and Pam Hanlon. And groomsmen, everybody, please put your hands together to welcome Shannon Davis and Rob Clairline. Yeah! Next up, we have Kristen Rushing and Rob Smolsky. Everybody, please welcome Jesse Richardson and John Silvina. Next, let's hear it for Angela Doyle, escorted by Greg Hayes and John Schofield. door, folks. So give a big hand for Melissa Hanlon, escorted by Danny Hocking and J.D. D'Angelo. Next, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our maid of honor and best man, Stephanie Yates and Kyle Pete. Introduce the two special people that brought us all together this evening. So please, everyone, if you could stand at this time, please get on your feet, because here they are, your bride and groom, the new Mr. and Mrs. Aaron and Julie Hanlon. Please be seated at this time.
There's no one else but us.
gentlemen, once again, please put your hands together for your bride and groom.
What I'd like to start with, if you don't mind, can I ask everybody to bow their heads and share in a moment of silence in memory of our daughter, Stacy. I know we wish she was here, but she's watching over her little sister, I'm sure. Okay, thank you. Now I'm going to tell you a little bit about Julie. She's probably scared to death. She didn't know I was going to do this. She's always been, let's say, a little adventurous. And let me explain what adventurous means to Julie. It's pretty much synonymous with me and Suzanne saying, don't do that, it's too dangerous. We're doing it anyway. That's her adventurous. It's kind of like when she was a little girl, about 4 or 5 years old, she used to climb trees that were probably 40 or 50 foot high, and we'd all be standing at the bottom of the tree begging her to come down, and of course, that just caused her to sway back and forth in the tree. So, that was her idea of adventure. Maybe I think when she was probably 11 or 12 years old, actually, I'm a little bit without reading everywhere. When she was 11 or 12 years old, she was a pretty good gymnast. And we would go to these gym meets, and she would be flying through the air and flipping on bars and balance beam and whatnot. And of course, Suzanne's heart and my heart were in her hands, scared to death she was going to get hurt. And one time, Sue asked her, she said, well, aren't you scared of doing these things? And of course, Julie's answer was, no, the worst that can happen is I'll die. So then we got to the teenage years. Teenage years, gray hair, no hair. That's what comes from teenage years. Anyway, Julie spent a lot of time hanging out with her buddies. Somewhere out here is Jonathan and Kenny, here you go, and Eddie, I guess. And of course, little sweet Miss Sweet Innocent over here, Steph. That was one of the buddies. Let me tell you about Steph. She is very, very sweet. Innocent, not so much. Okay? So, and I'm not sure I even want to know what all the buddies were doing. But what I do know is that some of those times with the buddies, and people mistakenly thinking that I was a little overprotective. Not true. I wasn't. But what it did do, it earned me a few nicknames from the aforementioned buddies, like Psycho Dad, One Man SWAT Team. Hey guys, I know who you are, I know where you live. Well, guess what, buddies? There's a new sheriff in town. And guess what else? He's smarter, he's quicker, he has a gun, but he still has backup. Anyway, as we got to know Aaron and his wonderful family, we thought this is great. He's intelligent, hardworking, and has direction in his life. And over time, we learned Aaron is kind of adventurous too. What I mean that's different about him though, is that when Julie says, the worst that will happen is I'll go ahead and die if I go ahead with this. And Aaron says, I'll think about it, I'll analyze it, I'll engineer it. Then he explains it. You get my picture. And then he says, the worst that will happen is I'll die. And he goes ahead and does it. So the conclusion is that they're both crazy and they're made for each other. Okay, I'm almost done. Julie, I've always admired and been proud of your free spirit and open heart. You usually scared the crap out of me, but I still admire it. Aaron, nurture that in her, and you'll find the same joy that her mom and I have found watching her grow up. Have a wonderful marriage, and we love you.
Hi, I just want to say thanks for everyone for coming out, and thanks for Julie's family for putting this amazing wedding. Everything's beautiful, everything's perfect. Aaron's been like a brother to me for years. I mean, you know, I've known Aaron for 12 years, and, you know, we're just the best of friends. I mean, you know, when he told me he wanted me to be his best man, I was like, no problem, I got your back. And, you know, now that they're married, I have Julie, she's like, you know, going to be my sister now, she's awesome. So, you look very stunning today, by the way, you look amazing. But anyway, as I was saying, me and Aaron, you know, we've been best friends, you know, for a while. And, you know, I was thinking about this and writing my speech, and I was like, you know what? There comes a time in every man's life where he gets a new best friend. And I'm just glad it's someone that's, you know, as caring, loving as Julie is. So I hope you guys have a great honeymoon and a wonderful wedding. I love you guys.
My name is Stephanie, and Julie and I have been best friends for about 20 years. It truly is an honor to be here tonight on this occasion. Hi, Ellie. Surrounded by all our friends and family. Before I get started, I would like to thank Julie's parents, Mike and Sue, for hosting this amazing day. I think I can speak for the crowd when I say you outdone yourself. I once read that a person would be lucky to find one true friend in their entire lifetime. I guess I must have lucked out with Julie. Or is she the one that lucked out with me? I'm still trying to figure that one out. Our friendship has spanned the awkward and challenging grade school years, the independent and demanding college years, and still the years beyond all of that. We've traveled together through life's ups and downs, shared good times and bad times, laughter and tears. From the innocence of 10-year-old girls to grown young women, we are now sisters. We've had a lot of fun together, and she's been there for me like no one else. Besides, apparently, the other. Julie, I'm proud of your friend. You're a giving person, and I love you to pieces. The years pass so quickly, and no one can give them back with an old friend. You haven't truly lost them. On your wedding day, I'm reminded of the first time I learned about Aaron. Never knowing that years later, he would become your husband. Julie came over to my house, very excited, and she told me about this guy she had just met the night before. She approached him, she told me, because he was the only normal-looking guy in the crowd. Okay. They talked, and they just seemed to click. Great, I thought. Then she told me he was almost 5 years younger. I was nervous. He was only 22. I think I remembered being 22. Julie and I might have spent that entire year at the now closed but once classy establishment known as Bee's Pub. It didn't take long to realize I had nothing to worry about. Aaron was an old man trapped in a young man's body. What he lacked in age, he more than made up for in maturity. For example, on their first date, Aaron took Julie to Friendlies. I guess I've heard of other dates, Friendlies. Actually, I think it's one of my grandparents' favorite places to go. Over the next 3 years, I watched Julie and Aaron grow together as a couple, and I can't imagine a better match. Aaron is one of the kindest people I know. And patience, he has enough for three men. I know this because he has the ability to handle, probably tolerate, being a better word, Julie and I when we're together. And for those of you who know us, it's not always easy. So Aaron, as Julie's best friend, I'll pass on to you some of the wisdom I've gathered over the years, and you can thank me later. When Julie says she's hungry, find food. You only have a limited window of opportunity before it gets ugly. If it's late, don't let Julie cook. We've sent more than one client off the trash can and it gets expensive. If you're ready to leave, Julie won't be ready. Ask her at least 30 minutes before you're actually ready. If you ever want to sleep in again, invest in some quality earplugs. Julie's favorite time to talk is at about 6 a.m. Hide your leftovers. If you don't, they're fair game. And last, but most important, love Julie. Give her your whole heart. Your return on this investment will be far more lucrative than you could ever imagine. I want to congratulate Julie and Aaron on your wedding day, and I want to wish them the best of all that life has to offer. So please raise your glass to toast the happy couple.
Thank you so much. We can have a round of applause. Thank you.
put your hands together for our group. Scoot it on down. Alright, 35 years or less. Come on up. Come on over this way. Or less. Come on over. Alright, I'm going to jump this up to a milestone. 50 years or less. Come on over this way. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we found our winners. If I could, it's Bill and Jane Finnan, who have been married for 60 years. Let's hear it again for Bill and Jane, everybody. Very nice. Congratulations.
Yeah. ladies and gentlemen. The song to Stacy, Julie's sister.
Yes, come on, get it all, and the world's going to be a man to say.
Let's hear it for the groom.
Yes. So we're just going to move that chair out of the way as we get all the single fellas out onto the dance floor this time. All the single fellas, where are you at? There's got to be more than three, right? All the unmarried fellas, please report to the dance floor. How far he could get the garner up there. The further he goes, the luckier our couple will be in love, as long as he doesn't get smacked. There he goes, ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause, and let's get together for a nice photo.
I want to make sure that I thank everybody. It means a lot to see all of you here. It seems like there's always been a lot of people that have treated me like family. And this is the first time that they're all together. So, and it really does mean a lot. And I want to thank Michael for putting on this event for us. I'd like to give them all a round of applause, if we could. With all my families here, it's really nice to see y'all in one room. So, thank you. Have a good night.
You are the promise of my life. You are the promise of my life. Chemistry, it don't matter. Show my energy.